Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome back to another Cabela's Big Game Hunter Pro Hunts. Today is April 12th, 2014, which means it's Easter. Happy Easter, everybody, and thank you for watching this video on Easter if you are. If not, thank you for watching regardless. Today is a very special episode. Why, you ask? Because we are all geared up to head up to Rubble Ridge to take out the legendary
Hogzilla.
This big 800 to 850 pound boar is what we are going to attempt to take down today with a recurve bow. We have to get a minimum of 25 yards away, stay downwind of him, because this guy spooks very easily. So we've got ourselves a recurve bow, we've got two packs of 450 grain broadhead arrows, some scent mask, and our binoculars. Let's give it a go.
Today is your lucky day, buddy. Play your cards right, and you're going home with a great story to tell the grandkids.
You're about to meet a one-of-a-kind swine, the biggest, nastiest boar you'll ever see. The locals call him Hogzilla.
This monster boar is usually milling around in dense cover this time of day. Finding him isn't going to be easy. Hogs have a keen sense of hearing and a nose like a hound dog. You'll need to keep a low profile, watch your step, and stay downwind at all times.
You'll make a racket tromping through that brush, so try to move at the same time that boar does. Those giant pig feet will cover the noise of your own footsteps. You'll have to get close to pierce Hogzilla's hide with an arrow. Don't take a shot until the range is under 25 yards.
Stay calm, pick a spot, and good luck.
Here we go.
Now there's Hogzilla's living room, but hold on a second. The wind's at your back right now.
You go charging straight in, Hogzilla will be gone before you know it. Make sure the wind's in your favor before you go in after him.
Okay, the wind's at her back right now. Alright, there's our scent blowing right towards him. So, if it were me, and he's down there in that brush, we may have to circle all the way around and take the long way. We may have to circle all the way around this way, and then come in from that way. So we may have to just take a little stroll in the woods.
Ralph and Vicky Cianciarulo are waiting for you to return to the challenge. This is not a time to go sightseeing.
Oh. Okay, sorry. I thought I could just go roaming around that way. Gosh. So anyways, I was saying, we're just going to take a little stroll in the woods, you and I, on an Easter Sunday. Maybe we'll find the Easter Bunny out here. You never know. We're just going to stick to this rock line here. Oh my gosh. They just flew right through the rock. Last I saw him, he was over there in those shrubs somewhere. Okay, so now the wind is facing kind of at our side. We need to keep going. Oh, there he is right there. I think he was even looking right at me. Shoot, I think I was making way too much noise. Did he settle down? Yeah, he did. He went back to eating. Alright, so we're going to move in on this guy. The wind is right in front of us. We are downwind from him. So that's our cue. He was rustling through some shrubs, so we should be able to get a little closer. Alright, so patience is key here with this hunt. Big time. We need to take our time, get within 25 yards, and take a clean shot at him. There he is right there. He's just, I think he might actually swing around here. Oh shoot, he's coming right towards us, guys. There he is right there. I think he might actually walk right towards us, guys. Right lung. There we go, guys. Oh, and his left lung. Double lung. Clean through. And there he goes.
Right on target. I can already smell the barbecue.
Way to go. What are you waiting for? Go claim your trophy.
Sorry, I got a little excited. I can't believe we finally took down the legendary Hogzilla. Wow. That thing is huge. 830 pounds. Today was a good day. Very good day.
You know, big old boar hunting's always a rush, especially when they charge. It really gets that adrenaline pumping.
Everybody sees those big tusks, and that's what they care about. But their meat is great eating, too. Back home, we call them Barbies, because they barbecue up so well.
Oh, you guys are so funny. The legendary Hogzilla is down. Alright, what do we got going on here? So we need a 12 gauge pump action shotgun now. So let's go ahead and go purchase that really quick. I think it's down here towards the bottom for $15,000. Okay, so we purchased a 12 gauge shotgun. We are going to need... What did we need for that hunt? We need 12 gauge slugs. 12 gauge slug. We have 12 gauge bird shot. We want 12 gauge slug. All right, here we go. Now we should be able to do this hunt. Hunt three boars with a shotgun. I didn't know you can lay down. Ooh, we've already got boar right down here in the valley. We need to hunt three of these bad boys. So, ribs, right lung. clean through. And broke his ribs on the other side.
Lung shot, nice and clean. I don't expect you'll get another good shot here today. The local game needs some time to settle down.
Alright, so he fell up there somewhere on the hill. Okay, we're gonna go track this trophy down real quick. He should have just fell right up here on the hill somewhere. There he is, and it looks like the rest of the boars went running up over the hill, so we may have another chance at taking those guys since the wind is facing right at us. Nice.
Great! Two more to go.
Yep. Here they are, right up here. That fox scared the heck out of me. Oh God, he's coming right at me. Oh God. He's charging.
That's a shame. Sloppy shooting and painful too.
Oh God, he's still coming at me. Come on, breakthrough. Breakthrough. Hit his heart. Oh God.
That's a shame. Sloppy shooting and painful too. Next time, wait to...
This thing's turning and running. Stomach shot. That's not good. We're gonna lose points in this one.
Right on target. Shooting a running animal is challenging, but also risky.
Right in his stomach again. My goodness. This guy just got wrecked. Double stomach.
Right on target. Shooting a running animal is challenging, but also risky. In the future, wait until your target is stationary to ensure a clean kill.
I'm gonna lose a lot of points for this guy. I didn't realize he was right there and was gonna run up on me like that. Yeah, we lost 200 points for that one.
You need one more trophy to finish the hunt.
What do I hear up here? Oh, shoot. We got a buck sleeping right there. I wonder if I can hit that animal just because. No, let's back off. We don't have tags for it. But then again, people said we can shoot those things and get extra points. Let's see what happens if we hit him. Right lung.
Right on target. Shooting a running animal is challenging, but also risky. In the future, wait until your target is stationary to ensure a clean kill.
He's not going to get very far.
I don't expect you'll get another good shot here today. The local game needs some time to settle down.
I guess we can. Good call, guys. I didn't think we could actually, you know, hunt other animals on another hunt. Wow. Okay. Well, we got it. Actually, we made up for that pig that we screwed up a minute ago. So that we got 70% hunting pressure there. Looks like they could possibly be in this feeding area over here. So let's go head over this way. I've only got, what, about 6 shots left in my shotgun, so we gotta make sure we hit this guy on target. That didn't work too well.
Stay alert for shifting winds. Keep downwind your target.
I actually am downwind. It shifted in my favor. Very, very open area here. So we're about 180 yards out now. We're gonna slow it down a little bit. We only need one more of these boar. Whether or not they're here is another story. I'm not seeing anything. Alright, so they're not feeding there, so there's a good chance they could be down this way. So we'll head over this way and see if maybe they're feeding in this area. We are perfectly downwind from them as well, if they're going to be here. Not hearing anything here either. Looks like they could also be up here feeding as well. All right, let's jog across this valley here. Because it looks like they could be just over this hill line. Did you hear that? Or am I hearing things? I think I'm hearing things. I'm not picking up anything over here either. And they could also be way over here too. There they are. .450 pounder. 200. Whoa. Look at that big boy. Right? There. 850-pound boar. We're gonna flag that big boy right there. So I'm gonna take the long way here. Shoot, it's gonna put me upwind from him. No, it's not. I'm just glad. Yes, it will put me upwind from him. If I can't get a shot on that big boy, I won't take it. I'll take one of the other ones, but man, I want that 850-pounder. That's a good chunk of money right there.
Watch the wind. You don't want to be caught flat-footed if you're suddenly upwind of the animals.
The wind actually shifted a little bit in our favor. Just a little bit, not much. I think that's her boy right there. Yep, that's him. The lead one right there. That's our boy right there. I'm gonna crawl up to this bush over here. Shoot, he's walking away from us. I'm gonna crawl and see if I can't get to this bush and then take my shot. The wind is blowing, luckily, over the pond. So they shouldn't catch wind of us. I don't think I'm gonna get a shot on that big boy. Yikes. He's walking away. Gosh dang it. I may just have to settle for one of these guys here. I just don't think that this slug is gonna travel that far. That's a crazy shot from here. Very crazy shot. I really want that guy, though. I'll just take this guy for now. There we go. Lung and stomach.
That's sloppy shooting, friend. We always aim for a quick, clean kill. Next time, put your sights just behind the shoulder bone.
Not only did we get the big one we wanted, never use slug ammunition to hunt birds, it's illegal. I guess I accidentally hit it, or actually hit it. Yeah, we lost a little bit of money on that one. But we got it nonetheless. Sloppy shooting, but we got 6,300 credits for that. That's a chunk of money. That'll make up for that shotgun we just had to buy. All right, ladies and gentlemen. When we come back, we've now got ourselves another buck hunt we've got to do. We got to hunt 3 8-point plus white-tailed deer. And on top of that, we've got the legendary pincushion. So we got to hunt this guy with a heart, lung, or a spine shot with a 4x rifle scope and a 270 bolt action. So, hope you guys enjoyed some more Cabela's, and we'll see you guys next time.